How do I want to start this? I want to start this like I start everything, without thinking and just diving straight. Because we are out of practice. This
well,
is,
it's been a while.
It's been a while, like that song by Stain. It's been a while.
I was gonna say this is how it should open.
You, this is pretty much it. That's all it is.
It should open with you saying it's been a while. Will YouTube take us down if you sing it? If you sing it.
I don't think YouTube will take us down for singing a song.
Put it in a minor key and only sing 8 bars.
No one watches this anyway, so it's not like we're gonna get a copyright strike from fucking Aaron, whatever his name is, from Stain.
It's algorithm.
Who cares?
Like the Emperor, we have returned.
We have returned.
With no explanation whatsoever. We're back.
Like heartburn, like heartbreak, we have returned. We're talking Star Wars. We're talking Last Jedi. We're talking Rise of Skywalker. We're probably going to talk Mandalorian. We're talking Star Wars Shadows of the Empire with Dash Rendar and Prince Xizor. We're talking Star Wars. We're talking Star Wars. And mostly, I think we are going to have one of our most animated discussions yet. And I don't mean animated like that Ewoks animated feature. Ah, or the Clone cartoon. Wars cartoons. I mean animated like Kris might yell.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
I looked forward to this so much
because
I saw a trailer with a snapping lightsaber that turned into a double-edged lightsaber, and I was like, fuck yes. And I knew it was a Force vision, because I'm not a fucking rube.
I rewatched Force Awakens, which I had not watched in a very long time.
Right.
And it didn't upset me as much as it did at the time. I think mostly because of Last Jedi, though. Like, because I allowed Force Awakens. I'm like, fine, you need it to be a movie we've already seen. You need it to remind people, hey, you guys know Star Wars. Here's Star Wars again. We just put a nice bow on it.
We actually have never been able to put our Force Awakens video on YouTube because Mike Rogov got so drunk.
Oh, yeah.
The footage was unusable.
Was that really Force Awakens?
That was Force Awakens.
Holy
yeah.
Shit.
That was so long ago that we weren't able to use that.
And then I rewatched Last Jedi, which I still very much enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, cool, I'm on it up. I'm like, you know what? Maybe Rise of Skywalker is actually going to pick up the lead that Last Jedi... Because Last Jedi gave JJ basically a blank page for what to do with the next movie.
It did not
hardcore... But if anything, I will give
Last Jedi... It kind of fucked things over with
Luke
being like, I am a hologram in the Force.
No, but I'm okay with that. I love all that. All that was great. But the one thing it did is it actually paid off Force Awakens itself, like the title Force Awakens. Because Last Jedi actually shows it, like, you know, Broom Boy's got it. The Force has awakened. It's spreading out. You don't...
Right, and they touch on that in Rise of Skywalker,
but like, it democratized the Force.
Right.
You don't have to be a Skywalker or a fucking Kenobi, or a fucking Palpatine.
The many Kenobis there are in these films.
Like, Ryan Johnson actually took the idea of the Force Awakening and actually kind of did it. And that was Luke's sacrifice at the end.
He took the idea of the low-speed chase.
No, but that's...
Over 2 hours.
That's not what the movie's about, though.
No.
And that's what I liked. Last Jedi was about something. It had... That movie had shit to say.
It was the spire that lit the fire of hope.
Exactly. Luke sacrificed himself to light the fire of the rebellion. And I'm like, cool. But all that to say...
The beacons of Gondor have been lit for ages. The rebellion has been in full swing.
Hey, that's Force Awakens' issue. Why are they even a rebellion again? They should be in charge.
Why are they a rebellion? I feel like this is a good segue into like what the issues are with the trilogy.
Yes, explain all the misgivings Force Awakens had in not setting up the universe in any coherent way.
One of the problems that we have with Star Wars in general is it starts in the middle. It's the only franchise that's ever started in the middle of it and then had to go back and tell the first trilogy of stories and then the last trilogy to end it. And that's how George Lucas wanted it. He wanted somebody to, you know, come back eventually and set it up. But they establish very well in the opening crawl of A New Hope where, like, the Empire, the Rebellion, the amazing cinnamon bun hair, and Chrome Boy and the gold. It's great. But then we get to a point with Force Awakens, where it's just like, the galaxy is in disarray again, and then we're like, hold the fuck up. Yeah, 30 what? Years ago, but the shit good guys was good, fam. So like, we were solid, and but now the good guys, shit's fucked.
The good guys should be in charge after Return of the Jedi.
Yes,
and the universe is in disarray again, so...
If Star Wars taught us anything, it's that destabilizing governments and installing new heads of state should be stable.
But like I said in our review of Force Awakens, which no one ever saw, the issue with Force Awakens is that it was in such a hurry to reset the universe, the way things were in A New Hope.
Right.
You know, like, there's an empire again, but they're called the First Order. The good guys are rebels again, despite the fact that they should be the government. And...
This will be the final order.
I'm going to do that so
much. And then, you know, and they're like, Han's a smuggler again. It's like, whoa. Like, anyways.
Han was, like, shady as fuck.
Force Awakens is...
In Force Awakens.
But it was fine. I allowed it.
Right.
It reset it.
He allowed it. That's the only reason it got made. He called up JJ and said,
it was well made. It was watchable. It was
fun. J. Jonah Abramson, and it's me, Kris Larivière. I allow you to tell this story. And I get it, though.
But most importantly, the new characters were good. I'm like, cool. I'm like, pick up that stick and run with it. Which I feel The Last Jedi picked up the best things about Force Awakens and ran with it. The shitty things of Force Awakens, it mostly discarded unceremoniously.
Right.
So, again, your mileage will vary on that, on how much that bothers you. I thought that Last Jedi picked up all the good stuff from Force Awakens, all the shitty stuff. Like, oh, Emperor 2.0, fuck that shit. No one cares. It's not interesting. We've done it. Get rid of it.
You've contended for the last 20 years. 2 years. It just felt like 20. That the Emperor not being in these new movies is good.
Yes.
And Snoke being a puppet of something is not the real plot. Snoke is just an asshole to fill a power vacuum.
Exactly.
And then in this movie, surprise, Sheev is back. It's your boy, Sheev Palpatine.
I am the Senate.
Really, Rise of Skywalker
Before we dig into the minutiae.
Yeah, Rise of Skywalker
What are your general impressions?
Rise of Skywalker is peak Star Wars. It is so Star Wars, it has Kenner fucking branding somewhere in it.
Darth Vader sold separately.
Capture them alive!
It's not a good movie, but it's a very Star Wars movie. From a cinematic perspective, it spends so much time back, like, walking things back.
Yes.
The first act of the movie is them walking
everything back. But you liked it, overall.
Yeah, I had fun. I walked into it and I had fun. And then I walked out and I'm like, fuck, you know what? I had a lot of problems with that, but holy shit, I still had fun. When I got out of Last Jedi, I was like, that was a great movie, but what the genuine fuck are they going to do next with that universe? They've really fucked themselves over.
They've dwindled the
resources down to nothing.
Yeah,
so, of course, they have to, in the next movie, do a Deus Ex Machina.
No, they don't.
Where the rebellion comes back.
No,
yeah, if you do it. Otherwise, the Empire wins because they're just about to.
But could you, like, you know what a much more interesting version of what they do in Rise of Skywalker, which, to be fair, to Matt's point, JJ's a good director.
He can't end anything.
His sense of pacing is so tight. Like,
oh God.
He moves the story forward.
Yeah.
So when you're like, wait a minute, that makes no fucking sense. It doesn't matter.
We're on to the next cool thing.
Later, and we're on to something else.
In Star Wars, where people give a shit about the story.
I agree.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
No, but I mean, like, when I was a kid, I thought Return of the Jedi was just as good as Empire and New Hope. I thought they were all better, as good.
But yeah, I get it.
But as an adult now, I can look back and be like, ooh, Return of the Jedi, clearly the weaker of the three.
These movies are not high art, though. You're not going to sit here and look at, okay, but why are these things the way that they are for X reason or Y reason?
Unless
it's a human decision. If it's a plot decision about space wizards, yeah, fucking just hand wave it.
No, but I mean, but when it's a purple-haired person
keeping no one in the loop about her plan to get them to a secret planet, that's just a poor direction decision.
But at least there was a plan in the end. So at least in the end, it made sense.
Were they just like, hey, let's make a movie about them getting to a cool salt planet foxes.
But this one in the end, I'm just like...
Peak Star Wars, glass animal.
But this one in the end, I'm like, what? That was it? Like, all right.
I was stoked at the end of this because I'm like, cool. We have a yellow lightsaber that's canon and merchandising. That's all I need.
You're right. The Disney execs were very happy with the ending of the movie.
Can we all just agree that it was great that they didn't have another Death Star?
I was pissed.
But there was a Death Star.
There kind of was another
They have Death a sequence Star. On the Death Star.
Yeah, it was the one that... It was the second Death Star that got destroyed.
And every Star Destroyer was a Death Star in this one.
Every
they
Star Destroyer has a super weapon?
Thousands of Death Stars.
I can feel your anger.
What's your beef with my boy Sheev, man?
All right, so here's the thing.
You don't think that life can transcend death?
Ian McDiarmid is delightful.
Ian McDiarmid's a babe.
Always a joy.
Right?
But, so, here's the thing. I kept waiting. I'm like, I'm sure there'll be a reason for Palpatine being bad. Like, you know, I'm sure it'll make sense in the world. Like, explain it to me. Explain why it makes sense that he survived the Death Star being blown up after being tossed down the, the shaft and blown up. And then explain to me why thematically it makes sense for him to be back. And it really...
Here's why.
And so in the opening crawl...
If you're thrown down a shaft in Star Wars, you can't die.
In the opening crawl, when it's just like, the dead speak. And like, everyone received a transmission from Palpatine. I'm just like, oh, that's cool and interesting. I wish that was in the fucking movie. Because when the movie starts, everyone's like, yeah, we know Palpatine's back and no one kind of cares. Like, no one's like, what? No one's shocked about it? And it's just kind of like... So I kept waiting. I'm like, well, clearly the movie's going to have to give me information at some point.
Right.
About how and why the fuck he's in this movie. And so I waited patiently. And I sat through like 18 fetch quests. And I'm like, cool. I'm sure at some point this will make a lot of sense. And then the movie ended. And I'm like, Jesus fuck, it never made any sense. I have no idea why Palpatine was in this movie. I don't, and not a nerdy, I'm not a nerd like you about like how he survived and why, like.
Right.
But like, is the Palpatine in the movie physically the dude who was thrown down the shaft in the Death Star that blew up and eventually crashed on whatever planet they go to the wreckage? Like,
right.
Did he swim out and then what, hop on a ship and fly to his planet where he grew Death Stars? Where did all these people come from? So like, here's my main point with this movie.
Right.
And then... You have at it.
I like that we're doing this like a political debate. Rebuttal.
Yeah. But like the movie...
You'll have 2 minutes for your
The
rebuttal.
Movie makes a very big ask. But I mean, the movie makes a very big ask of the audience early on. You have to accept that A, Palpatine is back with no information explaining why that makes any sense. B, he somehow has an army. And I'm not sure why the First Order even needs an army, because by the end of Last Jedi, the First Order are basically winning the war and the Rebels are like... A couple ships.
There's like 7 people.
Yeah.
Right.
So like, so why does Kylo Ren even need a bunch more Star Destroyers? Like they should be handedly winning this war. So it makes not to explain where are all these people? How are they being like, where are all these people coming from who are manning these hundreds of Star Destroyers? So it makes a very big ask of the audience early on. And either you're like, cool, I accept it and let's move forward, or you don't. And I did not accept it. So cool. So I kept waiting the whole movie. I'm like, explain it to me. Make this make sense, JJ. And JJ's like,
no.
When you see that there are cloning tanks and you see that...
You mean the Snoke thing?
Yeah, when you see that there are cloning tanks on Exegol and you see that there are cultists there and you see that Luke miraculously got picked up by his friends on Bespin when he lost an arm when no one should have been there, the Force just guided his friends to him.
His sister.
It's the Force. I am the Force. The Force is with me. There are already huge leaps in logic that happened in this.
But
franchise.
That was shown on camera. Like,
right.
We understand how he got out.
We have to
had ended and Luke was on Bespin and in Jedi he's just back. He'd be like, how
we
the
have
fuck
to
did you get out of there?
So much in the first hour of this movie for them to do it. And I get it.
But none of that time is spent on explaining why Palpatine is alive and in this movie.
Because he was too pissed off to die. We've all seen John Wick. You know that if you're too mad, you don't die.
So it's not
you just come back cool.
So it's not just lazy screenwriting.
Oh, it's absolutely lazy screenwriting.
But you're just pissed off enough
that you can come back. The Force is one of those things where it's like, it's the living Force, right? Where if you're cool with it and you accept your death, you can live on. And yeah, as a Force ghost and raise X-Wings out of the mud because that's just what you get trained to do when you're a Padawan. Lesson 1, don't cut yourself with a lightsaber. Lesson 2, when you die, because we fight evil with laser swords, you raise a ship out of the mud because you do it to your student. That's lesson 2. So that's why the good guys just, they interfere with the Force in a very loose way, like lighting a tree on fire with lightning or raising a ship out of the mud. But if you're a bad guy, you come back and you're like, hey, you know what would be really neat? If I had a planet full of strobe lights and for some reason, a ceiling-mounted life support system that carries me around the room, like one of those weird things that your nephew or niece shows you at Christmas,
that was
that you kind don't of, care about and cool. they shove it in your face for 20 minutes, do it, Rey.
So you
kill him, Rey.
So you're okay with, like, so you bought it?
There's enough stupid logic in the Star Wars universe to fucking establish that this happens, so I'm absolutely okay. fine with it.
Dan,
we have fucking planets where people are completely underwater all the time. Naboo has a city full of weird fucking ear dudes. Yeah, they live underwater.
We have fish.
And there's no representation on the surface. We have fish, but they don't have domed cities, Kris.
Galloping guppies.
I think JJ did his best to close all of the new threads that he had been left in the second movie. And he went back to his original vision for...
I will.
I think he skipped back to the front of the trilogy.
I will agree that
he always wanted to do Palpatine in the second movie. I think
maybe.
I feel like that's why this is such a fucking.
Would have been nice if
hold
he set
the
it
fucking
up in the
phone.
First
we gotta. Well, he, I mean.
So if he always wanted to do Palpatine, why even do Snoke? Why the fuck do Snoke if your plan was always to bring Palpatine back?
Because he did Snoke through projections, and I feel like his Andy Serkis as a British guy instead of a Kiwi was using him as a villain. To frame a failed Palpatine clone, which I could buy the fuck out of that. I would buy that 100%.
I would absolutely buy that. Maybe.
Or Phasma being nothing but Phasma being another failed clone of somebody.
Who cares about Phasma?
I cared about Phasma because she was cool.
But you're an idiot.
You
never should have cared about her.
I shouldn't care about anything.
She
Life
was a character designed to sell a toy. She never had a character. She was never.
You're literally wearing a Batman shirt and hat. That dude is designed to sell nothing but comics.
At least Batman, the character, has character arcs in movies.
Why did you say that name?
Last Jedi picked up story threads from Force Awakens.
Right.
Like Luke decided to exile himself for 20 whatever amount of years. Whatever amount
which
of years
is,
he's gone.
Which is on brand for Jedi. Because think about it.
But like,
when Jedi go through something, they fuck off to another planet.
That's true.
Obi-Wan did it. Yoda definitely did it.
It's true.
And Luke is just like, these are the things I've been taught. And
exactly.
So off, I'm
so all the
fuck.
People were like, I didn't like Luke's character in Last Jedi. I'm like, also, it's Force Awakens' fault for saying that he abandoned everyone for 20 years.
You've got to find Luke. I kind of like the quest for King Arthur kind of thing. You know what I mean?
Again, Luke's a MacGuffin in Force Awakens. JJ 100%. Loves his fucking MacGuffins.
Yeah,
but anyways, the point is, Last Jedi at least picked up that thread, and picked up Rey's parentage thread, and it paid it off. There is an
I
answer.
I think it's so stupid.
But like, there's an answer.
That was such
to
a point
Rey's
of contention
parents
for us
in Last Jedi, and which to me, still having seen the JJ alternative, I still think the answer in Last Jedi is way better. And is much better for her character.
We will always disagree on this because
so
you have been a proponent of Rey being a nobody,
yes,
being just
absolutely
as important.
Yes.
And your whole thing is, you know, anybody can use the Force. The Force is accessible,
yes,
to anybody. And that's
democratize the Force.
And that's a nice message.
It's not about the 1%. Democratize the Force.
You're the Bernie Sanders of Star Wars.
Bernie Sanders would be fucking all over the Force.
He would be all
it's
over
It's not
the
about
Force.
The Skywalkers or the Palpatines or the Kenobis.
Why do we have 3% of Force users being able to take
controlling
TIE fighters out of the sky?
Homos in the military.
We need everyone to be able to do it.
I am rising in support.
Last Jedi is the Bernie of the Star Wars universe.
It's because no one will vote for it being the best. It's just, I love the idea that the Force is for everyone, but that has not historically been the case.
Yeah, exactly.
There have always been
seen that already.
People. We have
hence
seen it, but that's the
movies,
overarching thing of it.
Hence wanting new movies to do new things and show us new ideas.
Humans have always been obsessed with, like, the chosen one or, like, the leader among all because we're fucking sheep and we need a point.
Can I tell you something?
Yeah, go ahead.
Do you know what I think I dislike the most about the prequels?
Is this going to be a Jesus reference?
No.
Oh, it might be.
No, seriously. There's a lot of stuff that doesn't work about the prequels.
Okay.
But I think the fundamental flaw with the prequels is the whole Anakin being the chosen one, the prophecy thing. Like, none of that.
Well, he was created by Darth Plagueis.
And also that he's born of like, man, all of that shit is just terrible. And
we
just
almost
drags,
got you to go on a tirade against Christianity. And
everything
down. I was so close that we could twist it.
No, because there's a lot of good ideas in the prequels. Like the way that Palpatine rises to power and takes
right
over. Like,
controlling
all of that stuff,
both sides of the conflict.
Yeah, yeah. All
yeah
of that stuff is good.
It's
not
it's
well
great
executed, but the ideas on paper are good. But man, Anakin being the chosen one and like, man, that just drags everything down. And it
so
really.
So do you think that Rey being the chosen one for Palpatine's final order...
Okay, so
is
that's
a bad plot point, right, though.
So,
because I think that's fucking dope. I think for
him
to have this out of nowhere where he's cloned and he's brought back, and I think it's so dope for him to be like, you know what? I tried to come back and I couldn't, so I'm just going to make my granddaughter kill somebody.
No, all right.
And
so,
then when the hate is strong enough, I'm going to take over her body.
So here's the point.
I spent 80 years with a dick and now I shall have titties. That was his entire plan.
No, so here's...
Palpatine was secretly gay. You heard it here first. He wanted to suck a dick.
Homos in the military.
So here's the point I was going to make. So Last Jedi at least picked up story threads in Force Awakens and paid them off. Maybe you didn't like the payoffs that it gave you, but it gave you payoffs.
Right.
Other plot points that were like stupid and no one, and I didn't care about, it kind of just discarded.
Okay,
so but here's the thing, and then Rise of Skywalker comes in, and he's like, oh, we're going to take the answers that were given by the last movie and be like, well, we don't like that, so we're just going to undo it completely, which I think is a bigger, it's a shittier thing to do. Last Jedi at least picked up those story threads and carried them forward in a new, and I would say more interesting way, and Rise of Skywalker's like, nope, I take my toys, fuck you, I'm going home and doing my own movie.
It's the Eric Cartman move.
Screw you, sir. I'm going home.
Finn being force sensitive in the first movie. Kind of hinted at, right?
Sure.
Ignored it for all the Last Jedi.
It is ignored in the second one.
And I think that's a disservice to the character. Because
sure,
I think the rebellious stormtrooper is awesome.
It's not a thread that
I think fighting against an indoctrinated behavior is something that Star Wars should definitely explore more. So, and in this movie, JJ's like, I fucking gave you that on a silver platter that there could be two Force-sensitive people in the rebellion, mm-hmm. right?
Why just two?
Because reasons. And it's the inverse rule of two, right? Where the Sith had the rule of two, and now there's just the one Sith. Now you have the rule of two Jedi who are going to come back like Lethal Weapon because one's black and one's white. One's kind of feminine, the other's Danny Glover. It's going to be awesome.
So the big question going into this movie, which, again, was, you know, Last Jedi told us that Rey's parents were nobody.
Right.
Hence, forcing her to actually make a character-led choice and actually decide, who do you want to be? No one's going to tell you who you are, which you spent two movies being like, tell me who I am. And then they're like, you're nobody. You decide what you want to be.
Right.
And she decides, I'm going to be good. And she doesn't take Kylo's hand. She goes back and helps the Rebels. Blah, 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 blah. So now the question in this movie was like, so is that going to actually be the explanation? Or is JJ going to be like, actually.
The neckbeard, actually.
And then so the obvious thing is that she would have been a Skywalker, which I think was...
A Kenobi.
So here's the thing.
The longest time I was like, yeah, Obi-Wan got his fuck on, and that's Obi-Wan's granddaughter.
So I thought her being a Skywalker was the dumbest thing they could have done. But JJ surprised me. And out-dumbed my possibly dumbest idea.
Right.
And he made her Palpatine's granddaughter.
Right.
Which brings up a few questions.
Go on.
Immediately, when that information came up, I'm like, wait. But again, to the movie's credit, the movie gives you that information and then zips past it. Like, on to the next scene where we're getting a dagger and getting on a thing and doing a thing. But I was just like, wait a minute. Palpatine fucked someone and had a kid?
Yeah.
Who was that kid? Who was raised, like, was that kid bad? Was he not?
So let me ask you this.
And then,
stuff.
So first of all, Palpatine had a kid, which is just, like, news. And
sure.
I'm like, I guess?
Sure.
What? And then that kid had a daughter and then hid her away. It raises so many questions.
Right.
But so many questions. That it just blows past.
Riddle me this, Batman.
Yes.
If Palpatine has a kid, that's weird, right?
Mm-hmm.
But him training to be a Sith Lord in secret and keeping the secrets of his dark powers of the Force from, at that point in the galaxy, the very powerful and widespread Jedi Council,
yes.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Why?
Because the Jedi's sucked. And
the Jedi sucked.
No, man. I think it's a point that Lucas...
Jesus!
No, I think it's a point that Lucas... meant to make with the prequels.
Right.
I think it was kind of one of his grand theses, but it was kind of muddled.
Theses.
But I think it was kind of muddled and not handled well, and that's something The Last Jedi picked up on, which is the Jedi's sucked. The Jedi's in the prequels sucked.
Right.
They're a bunch of weird virgin fucking monks, and they're like, they were so into their own religion and their own shit that they didn't see this happening under their fucking noses.
Right.
And I think that's one of the big, points of the prequels, that the Jedi sucked.
By and large, the retcons that were done in this movie, where they walked back pretty much everything, like the Holdo maneuver being a viable offense against Star Destroyers, I guess, was a one in a million shot.
Right, which to be fair, I feel is how Last Jedi presented it. When she's like, I'm gonna do this, everyone's like, are you fucking crazy?
Like yeah.
I feel like the movie presented as like a psycho move.
Right.
Like it's a like, last ditch effort, like you got nothing else.
There's a good reason why you can't do it.
Yeah.
For the most part, because, you know, hyperspace calculations, there, we saw take droids to do.
But it's a kamikaze mission.
Right. Right? But what the whole the point of that is...
The Rebellion like, no, doesn't have the people to sacrifice in kamikaze missions.
Not just people, it's ships.
Yeah.
Like, what's worth more, a giant fucking aircraft carrier or some guy from Alabama?
But when an X-Wing can go that fast...
X-Wings can go that fast, but you have to have an astromech droid. Like, it's the resources required.
This is a movie about space wizards with laser swords.
That's exactly it. Well, then, yeah. Nothing nothing matters. Let's go watch TV. That's what I get from these movies, and that's why I had zero problems with the retcons, the walking back. Don't get me wrong. There's a lot about this movie where I'm like, that's fucking dumb, but I still enjoyed it as a Star Wars movie more than I enjoyed The Last Jedi as a Star Wars movie. Last Jedi as a Star Wars movie... takes me out of it.
But what do we want from our Star Wars movie?
If you don't like Rey as the end of this series, you hate women. That's what I'm getting from this.
That fucking Chewie scene.
The Chewbacca scene where Rey force lightens.
So here's the thing.
Sha-na-na-na-na.
For a moment.
Fa-na-na-na-na-na. Like, yeah.
For a moment, this movie actually really got me. So that moment when she's like trying to like bring the, you know, so Chewie between scenes gets abducted.
Right.
I mean, we don't have time to show it because this movie's got like three plots to fucking serve. It's got three movies worth of plots to serve.
Just one, the final plot.
No, two. There's at least two movies in this.
The final
plot. So here's the thing. So Chewie gets kidnapped by guards and gets taken up on a ship. Cool. And Rey's trying to like fucking bring it down. And then Kylo shows up and he's trying to bring it down on his end. So they're like, you know, having that force off.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, all right. But then when she zapped lightning at it and like blew it up, and I was like, oh my God. Like, I was surprised. I was like, wow, that is a powerful moment. And like, and it, you know, as a character beat for Rey, would have fucking scarred her.
But thank God 5 seconds later we got that scene showing that Chewbacca was alive, because...
But 5 fucking seconds later they undo it!
Here's the thing.
And it robs the entire scene of any point or meaning.
You can't kill Chewbacca twice.
Why not? Why can't you just fucking kill him? Why not? What else does he have to do?
First of all, it's animal abuse, so that's rude.
No, man. That's the problem with this movie. They're like, we're gonna do something ballsy, and then we're gonna undo it a minute later.
I'm fine with that. Chewbacca needs to be there to get his medal.
Chewie dies. Oh, wait, no. Like, is there, like, I want to see the alternate angle where they just shoot her after she shoots the lightning. There's just, like, another identical ship, like, take out behind her with Chewie on it. Oh, no, wait, there he is. He's right
That's
over
probably
there.
What it actually is, but we're never going to get to see that.
And then they're like, we're going to kill Kylo, but immediately resuscitate him, like, 30 seconds later.
Which was
every
awesome.
Single dramatic decision this movie makes, it immediately undercuts itself.
But she learned how to be better. By killing him, she learned how to resurrect him, and therefore he is now Jesus.
I didn't...
He's the Holy Spirit.
At least that moment worked.
He's the Father, Son.
It paid off her evolution, whereas the Chewie thing just was fucking stupid, and they should have just killed him. Should have just killed him. It would have actually made Rey's fear of turning to the dark side like way more palpable that she actually just killed Chewie by accident.
So the,
like, it's so much more powerful.
Yeah, you don't have to kill him.
They just didn't have to show us that he survived until Rey found out.
But why not? Why not?
Because as the audience, we didn't... The whole reason they showed Chewie being alive again...
Yeah, it's like,
us,
don't worry, don't worry.
Not for anybody else.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he totally could have survived. It doesn't hurt.
I was immediately relieved. I was like, oh, damn. And then I'm like, oh, cool, he's back. Nice.
Don't worry. Any drama in this movie has been immediately diffused. Don't worry, nerds. Your fairy toys are still going to be around by the end of this.
Like, wouldn't it have been cool
your fairy toys.
To
we are... This risk-averse movie ain't going to rock the boat. Don't worry, nerds.
Like,
you're good.
Like, if she had gotten to that Star Destroyer, and, like, when she set foot on that Star Destroyer, used the Force to sense that Chewie was there, and then...
See, I would have preferred if when she was on that Star Destroyer, she used the Force to crush it.
But it still robs her...
Like, just flex her Force muscles and fucking crush
even,
the ship.
But Chewie being alive just robs her of any... guilt or impact from what she did,
right?
And hence watering down her character, you know. And I mean,
I don't think there's anything too watered
down. That movie,
she's basic
moment,
anyway.
That moment pissed me off. Like, what a waste of an opportunity. That the movie got really interesting for a split second, and then it immediately, like, don't worry, we're not gonna be that interesting.
I think it's still an interesting movie. I just think it's funny that we can't have nice things.
And again, like, this movie saw Endgame, and they're like, we should get us some of that shit. So at the end,
how is this like Endgame to you?
So at the end of the movie, when all hope is lost, and they're gonna lose the battle, and then the radio communication comes in, and Lando basically says, "On your left," it's just like, oh.
Hey, Chewbacca.
I like this moment better when I saw it in Endgame, and they all show up, but it doesn't matter because you don't know anyone. The only ship you recognize is the Falcon. So you're like, okay.
So you're going to tell me you're very familiar with all the Mon Calamari cruisers that are out there? Like, that's.
I'm just saying, why? So they did this in Last Jedi. They put out the distress call, no one answered. And then this time they're like, well, we're just going to do it again, but this time it'll work.
Yeah, it's because they're in a place where...
Emperor Skybeam was wrecking everything.
God, there was a Skybeam, too.
There was a Skybeam.
The Rise of Skybeam.
Why is Lando in this movie?
The only one that around that they either haven't killed off yet or is still alive in real life.
But you know what would have been a better use of him is, again, if...
You want to get Peter Mayhew in here? Like, what the fuck? Like, they have to use Lando because, you know,
What other OT character is still alive?
There's another black person in this movie who now is the father of Lando's...
I'd argue you don't need Lando at all.
No, you don't.
But it would have been a better use if he only showed up at the end and been like, I heard you need pilots. I heard you need help.
Yeah, it would have been great.
And he rolled it at the end. Like, literally everyone across the galaxy coming together.
It would have been nice to see that. Nicer. But I like that they showed him on Celebration Planet because they went during Hanukkah or whatever it was.
Oh, their Burning Man festival?
They're Burning Man. They're burning Hanukkah. Yeah, I mean, same thing.
What about Chewie getting a medal at the end?
Chewie getting a medal was dope. That was lit.
Chewie getting the medal is the stupidest fucking shit I've ever seen.
I've never seen you react so violently to a statement set off camera than you just did. You get pissed off. I've never seen you almost vomit. Like, that was like someone just said to you, progressive rock isn't all that good. Like, you got so mad.
Don't you fucking touch my 2112.
With six words. It's so good.
All right, so let's walk through this.
Go on.
Why does Maz Kanata give Chewie a medal? Is it for the Battle of Yavin from like 30 years ago?
We don't know.
Is it for what he did in this movie? And if so, why only Chewie? Why did only Chewie get a medal? Why didn't everyone get a medal? Why the fuck did she have a medal? Why is Maz Kanata in this fucking movie to begin with? Does she even exist?
Well.
Like, why did Chewie get a medal? It is so stupid.
Maybe he needed a medal.
No, it's for all those fucking nerds who are like, in A New Hope, it's kind of weird that they didn't give Chewie a medal. And JJ's like, don't worry, nerds, I got your back. He's going to get his medal. Was it weird for Lando when he went back in the Falcon in this movie? He's like, oh yeah, my like robot girlfriend's soul is in this ship.
Well, no, because he's already been in it since...
Did that seem weird for him?
Well, no, he was in it in Return of the Jedi.
Was it weird for them?
Probably not.
Is there like an access port somewhere that he uses?
Probably. He's got a fleshlight somewhere. Wrap it up. My whole point is, what do you want to see going forward?
Yeah, so listen.
There's two ways this can go, right? This can go in the far future. This can go in the far past.
You know what? I'm glad the Skywalker saga is wrapped up.
Right.
Because I'm sick of the Skywalkers. And I'm sick of
all
these people.
Everyone is.
So,
but what would you like to see?
Show me something new. Man, just fucking do something new. Show me something different. I don't want any existing characters. Like, just start a whole new storyline. Give me something new. So whether that's Knights of the Old Republic, or we blow past the new movies and we're like, we're moving forward.
If I get
now,
a Knights of the Old Republic series, I will be so fucking happy.
Even a trilogy of films. Like, you could easily make a three-film series out of Knights of the Old Republic, and it would be great.
It'd be amazing.
No existing characters. It's all new.
There's no Skywalkers. There's no Fetts.
There's no Yodas.
Also,
there's no Palpatine.
Shout out to the Clone Wars and the Mandalorian for not bringing in any of the Fett clan. The Fetts are pretenders. They're not real Mandalorians. They're little bitches.
Sure.
We all know this. But
the Mandalorian still brought in Baby Yoda. Well,
you leave the child alone.
To be fair, we don't know he's a Yoda yet. Like
we don't know he's a Yoda. Oh, what do his ears look like, Kris?
But you know what worries me?
His ears look? He looks like a cat to you.
But you know what worries me? They're saying season 2 of The Mandalorian will have more Skywalker era characters. that's a red flag for me. Like that.
You know what? I would actually love to see, as big of a red flag as that is for you, I would love to see Mark Hamill in a fuck, like putting spurs on his fucking boots and just walking through Mos Eisley with a lightsaber being like, get in my fucking tan.
I'm just saying, like were the issue.
And then using a racial slur for an alien we didn't know exist, because I think the idea of a racist Mark Hamill was hilarious.
But I mean, were the issues, like, after watching Mandalorian, like, yeah, that was good. Needs more characters I already know. It's like, no.
No, oh, sorry. I thought you were asking me if that was the thing. So what you'd like is something new.
Yes, I want something new. Just show me something new. Push the galaxy forward. Make the galaxy
larger. Great again.
Yes.
MAGA. Kris Larivier, MAGA supporter. Make a galaxy great again.
What do you want to see?
What do I want to see?
Yeah.
Honestly, I just want to see more Baby Yoda.
Space titties.
The only thing I don't want to see is another villain
that talks like this for two movies. I don't want to see this again, Rey. Give me your hand.
It sucks so much. Honestly, for me, the perfect ending to this whole Star Wars thing, because we're not going to get an ending as long as we live. I want to see another franchise another entry in this franchise that makes me excited about Star Wars again.
Yeah.
I'm not going to see this for a while. If we're getting another movie in 2 years, how excited can I be?
What's it going
to
be?
I've got Doctor Strange to look forward to in a year and a half, man.
I'm more excited about the videos the people I follow on fucking Pornhub are putting out.
You know what, man? I'm
not going to lie, though. At the end of Rise of Skywalker, I have a bit of an endgame vibe where I'm just like, cool, I think I'm good now. And I'm glad that there's not another Star Wars movie coming out already, the way that Spider-Man came out so soon after Endgame.
It was a nice epilogue.
Like, but after Rise of Skywalker, I'm like, cool. I'd be okay if they didn't... I don't need a Star Wars movie for, like, a few years. Like, give me at least 3 years before you do another Star Wars movie. Like, I'm good.
I'm good. Another kid.
You know what?
Yeah, do TV shows. That's fine.
Here's where I'm at.
The Mandalorian is delightful, and it's small scale, and none of it matters.
I want to see a Palpatine trilogy.
Oh, my God.
Look in your heart. You know it to be true.
Hero Han Solo.
So yeah, so that's so Star Wars is gonna continue on till we die.
Well, here's to Star Wars and here's to death, really.
Death.